Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Self Love Notes. If you have seen my previous videos, you must have known by now that I have been practicing self love, mindfulness and minimalism to live a simpler, happier and a peaceful life. I was inspired to bring these new changes into my life to bring more balance in my work and life. I think slow living helped me a lot to recover my nervous system and improve the overall quality of life. Honestly, slow living in cities isn't easy, but it is possible with some small and practical changes. So in today's video, I'm going to share 5 strategies that I implemented in my life to remain calm in this hustle and bustle of a city life. We all know modern life is fast-paced. We've been conditioned to do things more, better and quicker. Somewhere, being busy is glorified in our society. If we are not making the most of our second, we are considered unproductive and unsuccessful. Slowing down means taking a step back from all that. It means leaving the rat race and intentionally choosing a life where you accept the flow of life. We all have habits of multitasking because it makes us feel rushed and productive. Slowing down means sitting with your lunch and eating it mindfully, enjoying and relishing every bite instead of answering those emails or calls or attending those phone notifications. Slowing down means being present to the calm moments and enjoying the surroundings. It means filling your life with the things that you love. It is time for us to reframe our mind that it is not time wasted, but a time well spent. A big part of my slow living includes doing one thing at a time and try to keep multitasking at minimum. A part of me also dreams of living in a cottage with a luscious green garden, which is associated with slow living. But like most of you, we also live in an apartment tower with noisy street. But we can still make it out, work for ourselves and not keep slow living a weekend thing or a distant dream. A clean, clutter-free and a cozy home gives us that chance to rest and recharge. So a regular session of cleaning of home is important as it can help us to fill our homes with calmness and keep it stress-free. Dust, piles of laundry or an untidy bed can be overwhelming and depressing. So it is best if we keep our homes clean and empty even if we are busy. It is essential that we come to a home which fills us with calmness and not add to our anxiety. I always attempt to keep my room clean and empty in advance so that after a bustling day out, I come to a space which helps me to relax and not add stress. Decking up our balconies with some green shrubs which are easy to maintain can help us to build a space where we can go and relax and spend our little oasis moments. Honestly, living in an apartment house with no space for garden or balcony, I have still gone ahead and built a space of greenery for myself with few potted plants on our windowsills. Even though they don't look like a luscious green garden, it doesn't matter to me because it helps me to relax and remain calm. We are so accustomed to noise, distractions and activities that we almost feel unproductive if we don't have them. However, the opposite is true. We get more results and we stay motivated when we do things in stillness, in slow pace with consistency. Adding slow routines like sipping your coffee on the balcony or practicing mindful walking or spending 15 minutes of meditation in the evening, or just doing nothing but just sitting in silence can help us to understand ourselves better. Sometimes it helps us to understand our fears, our worries, our priorities in a better way. It helps us to recognize that what matters to us and what doesn't matter to us. For me, taking my lunch away from my desk may seem a little unproductive for others, but for me, it helps to increase my productivity. We all know big cities are filled with highly stimulating activities, and it is really very tempting to say no to those last minute email replies, phone notifications, or no to those social events. Evenings are basically for relaxing and resting, but we still end up filling it with productive moments. We still want to insanely scroll social media, shop or watch TV. Slowing down means just being with yourself in silence. Slowing down means saying no to these distractions. Saying no to the things which are taking your me time from you. We can fill these moments with just being with ourselves and doing nothing and just being present to our stillness. Taking time for yourself, decluttering your space, saying no to those distractions, it definitely takes time. Trust me, I understand. I hope you have taken something from this video which helps you to reduce stress and slow down. If you liked my video, please give a thumbs up and do leave a comment. Hope to see you in this next video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.